So when you work in software or game development, especially on a team, it's important that you understand version control. Version control is a way to keep track of changes made to a project. It helps you divide up tasks and responsibilities, see who made what changes, as well as just revert back to an old version if something went wrong. It's especially important when working on game development because you have so many people on the team, it's hard to keep track of who's making what changes. One popular tool for managing version control is GitHub. It's a website and a software that helps you manage and save your changes. And today we're going to be setting up your GitHub and getting you ready to push your projects there. Okay, so here's GitHub, pretty straightforward. We're going to take you from zero to version control master. All right, so let's create a new account. We're going to fill out the info. Let's fill out our email, password, pick a username. This is going to be your GitHub name. All right, so let's just do the classic verification. Get the code from email. And so now, you know, just set the settings. It's just you and you're not a student, so just click continue. Skip personalization. All right, and we have a GitHub account. Now we're going to download Git, which will let you use Git commands and push and pull changes through your command prompt. So head over to git-scm.com/downloads, which I'll provide that link in the description. All right, so click Windows 64-bit, and let's download the standalone installer. All right, once it's installed, let's open it up, install it to the default path. Make sure you check Windows Explorer integration, and then click Next. Also, the default Git is good here, so let's click Next. All right, here instead of Vim, we're going to put Notepad as the default editor because, you know, it's just simpler like this. Let's click Next. All right, for the next one, let's let Git decide. Now have Git from command line, which lets us use command prompt. Default is good here, and here, and here too. Here, let's use the Windows default console. The default is fine here. And for this one, let's select Git Credential Manager, click Next. The default's here and here. Now let's click Install. All right, once it's done, let's uncheck Release Notes and hit Finish. Now you should be able to pop in your File Explorer and at the top type CMD to open the command prompt. And if everything's installed correctly, then you can type Git and you'll see this screen. So now that that's done, let's hop over to GitHub and create a repository. You can name it anything you want. It's just a test. I made mine private, and let's create it. So now that we're at this page, all you have to do is copy this HTTPS link. All right, and now we're going back to command prompt. Let's type mkdir, which is like make directory, and then I'm going to put git-test, and that's going to make a git test folder. And now you type cd git test, and that'll get into the folder. So once you're in that folder in command prompt, you're going to type git clone and then paste that link, which is going to clone the repository into the folder. It's going to authenticate you through GitHub, so just go through and accept it. Let's get that all set up. And so now the repository is cloned, we can navigate to that folder. Inside that folder, you should have another folder with the name of the Git repo. Open that folder, make sure to check hidden items, cut out the .git file, and then paste that into the main folder. You can also delete the empty one. Now let's just create a file in here so we can test it out. I'm creating an empty text file. Let's call it Mariah Carey. So once that's done, we can go back to command prompt. Make sure you're in the correct folder. If you aren't, then you got to go back to the test folder. In the top, type CMD, and that'll open up the command prompt in the correct path. And so now we're going to type git add period, which is going to add all the change files to the push. When you type git status, that'll show that everything's looking good. Once we see it was added, we can commit. We're going to type git commit hyphen m and then the name of our commit in quotes, like this, test Mariah Carey. Now, one more step before it goes, we're going to type git push origin main and have it pushed to GitHub. And so if we refresh the page, we're no longer going to have an empty repository. See, here's Mariah Carey and the name of our commit, which is test Mariah Carey. Now let's delete the file and try it again. Git add period to submit the changes. Git status, it'll show deleted, perfect. Git commit hyphen m, by Mariah. Git push origin main, refresh, and there we go. It's reflected on GitHub. See, it was easy, wasn't it? It's definitely a must if you want to get a job in software or game development to learn version control. It also is good practice to use on your own projects because it makes the changes a lot less destructive. Thanks so much, and I hope you enjoyed this. If you want to see more tutorials or a big fat head talking on the camera, consider subscribing. Come join the Discord. It'll be a great time. Thank you.